Okay, I'm back. I have a few products to try. I have my usual routine and my husband in the background. So we're just gonna throw all this together and see what happens. Whatever, that's life. I have a husband. Okay, anybody that knows me knows that I love Tarte. I love Ulta. I love things that I can try, and my BoxyCharm box, I love it also. But today I'm going to try Farmasi's primer and what do I have? VFX Camera Ready Retouch Skin Visual Effect Foundation. Can you read that? You can't read that. You can read that. Whatever. I'll put it in the description. But one of my mom's best friends have started selling this and using it, and so she gave me a sample of it to try to see if I liked it. And I mean, if you're gonna give me a sample to try something, I mean, you've got to believe in your product. Which she said that she wore her foundation for 24 hours just to see, just for my curiosity, really, because I was like, does it last? And then 2 days later, she said, I wore my makeup overnight. It's horrible for your skin, but she did it. So anyways, I'm putting on the primer. Oh, she was not kidding. It just feels like velvet on your face. And I use a lot, so I thought I got enough for 2 applications, but I think I got enough for 1. It does. It feels so good. I want this over my entire body. Oh, but you know what? I got my hands oily before I opened this package. Time out. Okay, try this again. She gave me level number 3. Oh, that's gonna be so dark on me. I'm not this dark. My mama's this dark. TT, I needed lighter. Okay, since this is so dark, oh my gosh, that goes on so good though. Well, I mean, I'll definitely be able to tell if it comes off anywhere. And usually I like lighter foundations because I can use my bronzer and darken it up to my shade. But I guess it's gonna blend anyway and it'll be fine. I wonder if you can tell. Can you tell? Do I look dirty? I don't know. As long as I don't look orange or yellow, I'm okay. And now I have to go wash my hands. I didn't think this through. Okay. We're doing this again. My face is dry. My hands are clean. My camera's focused. Maybe I won't have to stop again. Who knows? After this color sat on my face and dried, I can tell just a little bit of a shade difference, but I really don't think it's gonna matter. I really don't. Especially not when my hair's down and the sun goes down. Nobody can tell but me. Maybe. Okay. So, I like to use my Morph palette for my eyebrows. I guess I will forever and always just like eyeshadow or powder on my eyebrows. And I always use an angled brush. For me, it just does better with pencil. It does better than pencils, I don't like the way pomades look. I just like that it looks more natural. Like, it's darker, it's filled in, it's more natural. But the fact that my eyebrows need to be waxed, now that's a different story. And I don't do perfect anything unless I'm working on somebody. Now that's a different story because I'm super OCD about everything. But on myself, I like to look more natural, but like highlighted. Just enhance naturalness. Now for eyeshadow, what am I going to use? I don't want to use my Morphe palette. I'm not feeling this. We're going out tonight because it's our anniversary. And I love this palette. And it actually came in my BoxyCharm box. And my child pulled it off my drawer or my desk at work. And it's busted now. But it did come with a little handy dandy mirror. But if you can see these colors, they are beautiful. And they go so well with me and my skin tone. So I absolutely love it, and that's something else I like about the BoxyCharm box, is they really customize it to the colors that you use, or even like your skin tones. So I like to take my lightest color, not white, well I mean pretty much it is white, and put it as close to my brow as possible. And there is some shimmer to it, which I don't know if you can see because of that glare. And then I'm going to use this color without, this color without the shimmer in it for my base. Because I do use so many shimmery colors whenever I do my makeup. But I do like this one base color. And it's a little bit lighter than my skin tone, so you can see a difference. And it provides a really good base for my next color, which is a darker color. When I was learning how to do makeup, I was just amazed at how many different colors go on your eye to make your eyeshadow look so good. And I've tried to minimize it, but I mean, I still need like four colors just to make it pretty. And I do. I usually stay more towards like beigey kind of colors. You know what? I was gonna use that. But instead, I'm gonna use my Naked palette without shimmers and probably this shade. Or this shade. Yeah, this one. Let's do that for tonight. I don't want to go too crazy because I just want to dress comfortable since it is a Tuesday night. Now whenever I watch this video and it's not Tuesday night, it's going to make me a little crazy, but it's okay. And I don't do things traditional like everybody else does. I kind of just use the brush that I have and make it do what I want. To me, there's no right or wrong way. As long as it looks good, I'm happy. So I've got that brown added, and I'm going to go back to my base brush and just kind of smooth out that edge so it's not such a harsh line. And then I'm going to take my darkest color and this little brush and just make little circles. I'm going to make little circles in my powder and I'm going to make little circles on my eye. Right there in that crease. I love that I can see my wrinkles in my forehead now. It's crazy when you turn 30 and you see all your wrinkles. They still don't bother me yet, but I constantly think about Botox. And then my bank account is just like, no. You're not there. I probably won't ever be there, honestly. I just don't know if I ever want to start that train ride. You see that? Eyeshadow. Feel like I'm too far from the camera. Can I scoot up? Let's get up. Ugh. Nothing. One of my absolute favorite things to do is contour. And I still use the Don't Be Afraid Double Duty Beauty Palette. And you can see that I've used it so much, I'm almost out and I need more. Mm-hmm. Oh. I love this brush to contour. I feel like it's just perfect. Can't hear my music anymore. Make my nose look smaller. Make my nose look smaller. This is another reason why I said it didn't really matter if my foundation looked too dark, because I knew I was going to put powder on anyway. Make that chin disappear. As long as I don't do this, I think I'm okay. And highlight. Highlight until you see it. Or just keep adding it if you want to, because I love highlight. I like this that came in our BoxyCharm box, but what I love is it, Ombre Radiance, because this color looks so pretty on my skin. So Avon's waterproof eyeliner has really been the only eyeliner I've ever been able to use to get on my eye where I want it and for it to stay. Especially putting it on that bottom line where I like it, it's been really hard for other eyeliners to go on right there. But I love this one. I love you. Be careful. Ooh, but I am going to use my Hank and Henry liquid eyeliner because I love it. Ugh, just look at that brush. Can you see that brush? Look at it. I think it's blurry. That's the hardest part. Maybe they're even. Are they even? I don't know. My eyes are watering. Don't cuss on camera. Don't cuss at all. I knew I forgot something. I like just a little bit of a lighter color on the inside. And sometimes I use highlighter. I have a new set of brushes and I still haven't brought myself to use them yet because they're so clean and black and perfect and I just love them so much. Moda Pro. I can't bring myself to use them yet, but I do have a lady who's coming in to get wedding makeup done. I think I'm going to save them for her. And then I'll clean them and use them on myself. So I'm going to take my smallest brush and my whitest color highlight. Love that color. And usually I just do stuff like this daily. The colors vary, but I mean this is pretty much the same technique I almost always use. And this is pretty much my face besides my mascara. Oh, that smells good. I know it's crazy, but I love this setting powder. And I usually use it before I put my spray on, but I forgot because I'm on camera. So, you know, you forget everything when you're on the spot. But this Becca powder, it goes on your skin cool. So it kind of feels damp. And it's just the best feeling. Like, I will continue to buy this. I love it so much. Even if it does go everywhere. Okay, so now. This, what is this? Violet Voss Essentials Pro Series Eyeshadow Palette. This, I'm giving away. And all you have to do is subscribe and leave a comment that you have subscribed to my YouTube, that you have done this. You can say done. You can say whatever you want to. You can leave me an emoji. As long as you comment, I will enter you to win this. Very pretty palette. Very pretty palette. I have a hair product obsession. I have a makeup collection. And I need to give some stuff away. So, good luck, guys. Really, I'm just going to do my mascara and I'm done. I don't do a whole lot of makeup. I mean, I feel like you spent more time watching me instead of actually learning anything, but who knows, I might have helped somebody. People ask me to help them with their makeup all the time, and unfortunately, this is the only way I really can, unless you come and see me at work. Ugh. The superhero It mascara got so clumpy. I need to soak it in some hot water just so it'll get off the bristles. And the only good thing about this Tarte Big Ego mascara is that I think I get a little bit of product. I swear, if I didn't see this getting a little dirty, I would think that there wasn't even any product in there, because literally I just kind of use it to separate my lashes. That's it. That is my hair. That is my makeup. I need to put mascara on my bottom lashes, but I'll do that off camera. Big hair, makeup. I'm good. I'm going on a date tonight. Don't know what I'm going to wear. Oh well. Snap you later.